Up team. So it's your girl, Prophetess Kimberly. So today I want to talk about catering to your man. All right. So everyone should hear this word. Amen. So I'm going to tell you guys a really, 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 really quick story that is going to bless your socks off. And a lot of women right now, you are praying. A lot of people, we can apply this to men too. All right. You're praying for your God-ordained spouse. Amen. So when you're single, you pray some stuff. You're like, okay, God, I'm gonna do this when I get a husband. God, I'm gonna do this, God, when I get a wife. But what about when God actually blesses you with that? And now you gotta put everything that you said you was gonna do to, like live it out, right? All right, so what do you mean? So I'm gonna tell you a quick story. All right, years ago, I went to this couple's house and this man, he was a God-fearing man. He sat down and I was just looking at him. He sat down, he sat on the couch. I know he was hungry, but he did not move. He didn't even go in the kitchen. He sat down in his recliner. He had, his little chair, like a little chair that you put the plates on or whatever, like that tray, a tray, like a eating tray. He had that set up. And his wife was so in tune with him. His wife was so in tune with him. She got up and she made his plate, his dinner, and she served her husband. So here I am, a young girl, a young woman around about 23, and I didn't understand it. I was like, why don't he just get up and make his own dinner? Like, ugh, So I said I would never do that. Now I'm doing that, you guys. What? So I'm going to talk about catering to your man, catering to your significant other. All right, and I believe it goes both ways. All right, so I taught a class about 2 months ago, I think j the end of July. Is called "I Need Help Becoming That Proverbs 31 Woman." So if you want that teaching, email me at info@kimberlyhargers.com, and I will, tell you how you can get that teaching. It is anointed. All right. So being that I'm a minister and I'm accountable to this word, and I taught something, I got to apply the word to my life, and I'm preaching to myself today. Amen. So we're gonna talk about catering to your man. So when I was lonely, in that lonely season, I was like, God, when I get my husband, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that, I'm gonna do this. So the other night, my man came home. He worked hard. He had a long, hard day at work. And I had cooked dinner. And I put the dinner on the stove. But every other time, I'm always making the plates. I'm always serving. The one thing I said I wasn't never going to do, I became that wife. Amen. So he came home. It was like late at night, almost midnight. And he's like, he woke me up out of my sleep. And he's like, baby, can you fix me something to eat? I'm hungry. So, initially my flesh rolls up like, how dare you? Who you wake, who you waking up this time of night? So I was like, okay. God, I remember when I was single and lonely and I didn't have no one to, other than my kids to cook for. So I'm like, okay. So I got up, I was like, sure. So I went in that kitchen. The dinner was already cooked on the stove. I just made this plate and I put up everything. Amen. So we're going to talk about catering to your man. All right. And you might say, Prophetess ain't scriptural. And a lot of people, they're probably not going to agree with me. But this is in Proverbs 31 woman. I taught about this kind of woman. All right. Some people look at her as, oh, she don't exist. But if you take the class that I taught, I will demystify, demyth all that stuff. Amen. So she's not superwoman. Amen. You can apply this. You can ask God to help you become a better woman, to become a better mom, to become a better you. All right, so let me give you this word, Proverbs 31. Amen. Proverbs 31, verse 15. So look at it. Get your swords out. Amen. Proverbs 31, verse 15. She also rises while it's yet night. Amen. She's getting up early. She's getting up late. All right, so she's a woman that's in charge of her household. She's a woman that takes care of her house. All right. And she provides food for her household. What? So you mean to tell me that she's gonna get up no matter what time of the day and Cook that man some food or make sure her family's taken care of? Yes. This is the kind of woman we are dealing with. A lot of women, and I'm preaching to myself right here. Ooch. A lot of women, you're just like, oh, go pick up something along the way or, do that. No, I'm too busy. I'm too tired. But it's a sacrifice, and you gotta look at marriage. And sometimes I know marriage is hard. Sometimes you may be, like kind of bumping heads a little bit, or sometimes you don't see eye to eye or agree on everything. But at the end of the day, you got to regroup, you got to refocus, and say, okay, marriage is a gift. God honors marriage. I'm going to work hard, on my marriage. So, my husband, I'm gonna set boundaries. He knows I'm not a slave, but if I've been serving him, while he's at home or just any all his meals, then of course he will come to me, when he just get off work at a long hard day and ask me, can I make his food? So being that I started that, amen, and I that was the standard that I set in this relationship, I need to keep it up. See, a lot of women, you start something but you don't finish it. You may start off looking all cute to get that man, but when you marry him, you just let yourself go. Your hair is a mess. You don't put on no makeup like you used to put on makeup. You used to dress cute in public, but now you don't even want to dress cute anymore. You just put on everything. Women, amen. I'm real talk. I'm gonna say this, amen. If you listen, throw away those holy underwear. Raggedy bras, and go get you something nice, amen. Save up. You can get some good things on clearance, amen. All right, give that man something nice to look at, and whatever you start in that marriage, you make sure you do it every day, or you make sure that you are consistent in doing that. So I'm talking about catering to your man, amen. And it can go both ways, all right. So my baby asked me the other day, babe, I've been working hard all day. I'm just tired. I just want to sit in a bathtub and just relax, out of my reverence for God, out of just respect for who he is, my husband. The word tells us women, to respect your own husband. Respect your husband. Men are looking for respect. All right, so I said, okay, sure. I'll run you a bath water. Amen. Even though I had a thousand other things to do, even though I was like trying to clean up this house and prepare dinner, one phone call. Think about the times where, you could have said, sure, baby, I'll run you bath water, but you had a bad attitude. So just look in the mirror and just say, okay, God, I want to do better. I want to cater to my husband. I want to cater to my wife. Baby, don't even cook today. Let's go out. Let me get the dishes today. You work really hard. Let me make the bed up. Let me vacuum. You just rest. I see you working hard. Amen. I start to feel the presence of God on this preaching. So a lot of women, you like the idea of marriage, but when it's actual time to perform, you just like, I don't know. What did I sign up for? Man, and you feel yourself getting overwhelmed and stressed out. Just think of it this way. Marriage is a ministry. Amen. And you may be a businesswoman, you may be in a marketplace, and you're like, oh my God, I don't have the time to cook. I don't have the time to take care of this house. Listen, you gotta set boundaries. Amen. What do you mean? All right, you're busy, working maybe 9 to 5 every day. When you get home, you don't even feel like it. How about you meal prep? Meal prep. It may take one day, maybe a Saturday, cook, prep the meals through Monday to Friday, and bam, you can have a nice dinner, family dinner, at 5 p.m. when you get off work with your family, or 5:30 or 6 o'clock, whatever time is dinner. All right. What about like, oh my God, like I can't keep the house in order. I've been working all day. I don't feel like doing all these dishes. All right, well, what about plastic plates and cups? So it'll be less time cleaning up. You can eat good food still. All right, so just set boundaries. Ask the Lord for wisdom. All right, just like I said, Proverbs 31:15, and it says, she also rises while is yet night. All right, so she is the kind of woman that's determined. She's ambitious, and she is going to do what it takes to take care of her household. And she, guess what? She provides food for her household. Amen. So what do you mean? All right, I comply this to my walk. All right, I wake up at 5 a.m. every day, Monday through Friday. You know, I'm up here making lunches for my kids so they can go to school. All right. Sometimes my babe asks me if he's hungry, he want some scrambled eggs and some toast. I'm cooking it. Amen. You know, I cook a bunch of food sometimes so we can have leftovers throughout the week. All right, so we're talking about catering to your man. All right, so give that man a massage. Amen. You know, cook for that man. Sit down and eat with that man. And just look in each other's eyes and say, babe, I love you. And just thank God. Thank God for marriage. Amen. Thank God that you have somebody to do life with. All right. So I love you. I pray that you cater to your man. You know, you're not his slave, but according to the word, all right, women, we got to step up. Amen. And I can talk all about gender roles and how things are flip-flop and mixed up or whatever like that. You know, be a woman. Amen. Walk in purpose, walk in destiny. You can still be a mom. I'm a mom. You can still be a housewife. Amen. And still fulfill the call of God on your life. All right. And be a good wife and be a good mother. All right, so cater to that man. I pray that you cater to your man. I bind up any rebellion and any division, any miscommunication, and I pray God's blessings and favor over you in Jesus' mighty name. All right, team. So I'm getting ready to end this. All right, deuces.